Hello everyone, welcome back to Chenda DIY. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a crop lace cardigan with bell sleeves. It is really easy pattern and friendly for beginners. And in this video, I also showing you how to make it bigger and how to measuring on your body. Okay, now let's get into the video. For this cardigan, I'm using mercerized cotton yarn, size 1 ply or size lace. You can use any type of yarn that's soft and thin, because for making this lace cardigan, you have to use a thin thread and soft. For the whole cardigan, I use 450 grams. For crochet hook, I'm using 1.6 mm. You can use 1.5 or 2 mm crochet hook. First, we are going to make the front part of the cardigan. For this cardigan, I'm making in size small. This is how the front part of my cardigan looks like. We are working from down here to upside. If you guys want to know how to get your own measurement, please measuring the front part of your body and then divide by 2 or separate it into 2 pieces, or you can measuring from the underarm part to the middle part of the body or the middle part of the chest. And now you got your own measurement. And this is how we measuring the front part of the cardigan. Next, we are going to make the foundation chains. To begin, make a slip knot. And chain long enough until you reach your measurement. For me, I make 67 chains and then add 3 more chains for the base. So I'm using this pink yarn. It is just a sample showing you how to make the V-stitch. After you reach your measurement, then don't forget to add 3 more chains. Next, we are going to make the V-stitch. To begin, for row 1, skip 3 chains and make double crochet into the 4th chain. To make double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2. And yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. Remember, for this chain 3 that we skip, also count as a stitch. After you have made a double crochet, then skip 2 chains and make double crochet into the 3rd chain. After you have made a double crochet, then chain 1 and make double crochet into the same loop. And now you got 2 double crochets with chain 1 in the same loop. And this is how we made the V-stitch. Next, skip 2 chains and keep repeating this by make double crochet into the 3rd chain. Then chain 1 and make another double crochet into the same loop. Keep repeating this until you have 3 last chains, then I will meet you back again. Thank you. after you had 3 last chains, then skip 2 chains and make the ball go straight into that last chain. And this is what the first row of the V stitch looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 2. Turn your work and make the ball crochet into the stitch near chain 2. After you have made a double crochet, then skip 2 stitches and make the double crochet into the 3rd stitch. Then chain 1. And make another double crochet into the same loop. Keep repeating this into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches, then I will meet you back again. After you had 2 last stitches, then we are going to skip 1 stitch and make a double crochet into this last stitch or a chain 3 stitch that we skip. And this is what the second row of the V stitch looks like. For the next row, we are going to repeat row 2 until you reach row 26. It is equal 6.5 inches length. If you guys want your cardigan longer, please add more rows. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 26. Like I said, if you guys want the cardigan longer, please add more rows before we make decreasing stitch. If you guys wonder how do I know my cardigan is long or short, and here it is how you're measuring it on your body. Place this front part that we reach row 26 on your chest, and you can see how it looks like, long or short. If you think it's still short, you can add more rows. Next, after you got your desired fit, then we are going to make the V-neck part by making decreasing stitch. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is. For row 27, chain 2, turn your work and make V-stitch until you have 4 last stitches. Then we are going to skip 3 stitches and make a double crochet into the 4th stitch. And this is how we made decrease. Next, for row 28, chain 2. Turn your work. Skip 3 stitches. And make V stitch into every stitch until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. For the next row, please keep repeating row 27 and row 28 until you reach row 45. It means that we are going to keep decreasing until you reach the shoulder measurement. For my shoulder measurement, it is equal 3.5 inches length. After you reach your shoulder measurement, then we are stop making decreasing stitch and just make a normal V stitch until we got the length of the front part of the cardigan. Continue from where your last stitch is for row 46 until row 54. Make V stitch until the end of the row. Like I said, start from row 46, we are stop making decreasing stitch. After you reach row 54, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. You must have 54 rows in total. And for the length of my front part of the cardigan, measuring from row 1 until row 54, it is equal 14 inches length. Next, please repeat the same thing to the other side. And now you got the front part of the cardigan. Next, we are going to make the back part of the cardigan. If you guys wondering how do I get my back part measurement, we got the back part measurement from the front part. So in the beginning that we made the front part of the cardigan, we start with 67 chains, right? So don't count the 3 more chains that we add for the base. For each side, I have 67 chains or 7.5 inches length. Plus it together, it is equal 134 chains. It is equal 15 inches length. So for the 134 chains or the 15 inches length, it is the measurement of the back part of my cardigan. For you guys that make different size from mine, just plus the measurement of your both front piece of the cardigan together. And then you got the back part measurement. So for making the back part, it is the same thing like we did at the front part. We use the V stitch the same. To begin, chain low enough until you reach your back measurement. Remember, don't forget to add 3 more chains for the base. And then from row 1 until row 48, just make normal V stitch. For the measurement from row 1 until row 48, it is equal 12 inches length. We are going to make decreasing stitch to make the back neckline. To make the back neckline, first we are going to fold the back part into 2 pieces and use stitch marker to mark at the middle part of it. Then count 8 V stitches away from the stitch marker and use stitch marker to mark at the stitch near the 8 V stitch. And then count the same number to the other side. Measuring from the first stitch marker until the third stitch marker, it is equal 5.5 inches length. To make it more wider, you can count more V stitches. Next, we are going to make the back shoulder part of the cardigan. So I'm gonna use this again as a sample showing you how to make the crease for the back shoulder or for the back neckline. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is for row 49, chain 2, turn your work and make V stitch into every stitch until you have 3 last stitches from the stitch marker, then I will meet you back again. After you have 3 last stitches from the stitch marker, then skip 2 stitches and make double crochet into the 3rd stitch that near stitch marker. And this is how we made the crease. It is the same thing like we did at the front part. Next, for row 50, chain 2, turn your work, skip 3 stitches and make V stitch into every stitch until the end of the row. For the next row, please keep repeating row 49 and row 50 until you reach row 54. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to make the second side. To begin, attach the yarn into the stitch that we mark. You can count it as row 1 or row 49, chain 2, then skip 2 stitches and make V stitch into every stitch until the end of the row. After you reach the end of the row, next for row 2 or row 50, chain 2, turn your work and make V stitch until you have 3 last stitches, then I will meet you back again. After you have 3 last stitches, then skip 2 stitches and make double crochet into the last stitch. Keep repeating row 49 and row 50 until you reach row 54, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what it looks like when we place both sides on top of each other. Next, we are going to connect both sides together by connect the shoulder part first. To begin, attach the yarn into both sides loop. And then chain one. Next, we are going to make single crochet both sides together. To make single crochet, insert the hook into both sides loop. Yarn over and pull through both loops. And now you got two loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through two loops. Keep repeating this into every stitch until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. Next, chain one and cut off the yarn. This is the wrong side of the cardigan. And this is what the right side looks like. Next, please repeat the same thing to the other side. Next, we are going to take the measurement of the upper arm for making the sleeves. To begin, count 24 rows from where we connected both sides together. And use stitch marker to mark at the 24th row. Then count the same number to the other side. For my upper arm circumference, it is equal 14 inches length. If you guys want it bigger, please count more rows and mark it. Next, turn it wrong side out and we are going to connect this part together. To begin, attach the yarn into both sides loop. And then chain one. Then make single crochet both sides together into every stitch until you reach the stitch marker. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the stitch marker, and this is what it looks like. Next, turn it right side out. And we are going to make the sleeves. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is, and then chain one and make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the chain one. I'm really sorry for this part, I also recorded too, but I missed it. After you reach the stitch near chain one stitch, then make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. Next, for row one, chain two. Then make double crochet into the stitch near chain 2. Then chain 1 and make another double crochet into the same loop. Then skip 2 stitches and repeat the same thing by make double crochet into the third stitch, chain one and make another double crochet into the same loop. Keep repeating this around until you have 3 last stitches, then I will meet you back again. After you had 3 last stitches, then skip 2 stitches and make double crochet into that last stitch. After you have made a double crochet, then make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch. Next, for row 2, chain 2. Turn your work skip 1 stitch that near chain 2 and make V stitch into every stitch around until you have 3 last stitches, then I will meet you back again. After you had 3 last stitches, then skip 2 stitches and make double crochet into that last stitch. After you have made a double crochet, then make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 50, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 50. For the measurement from row 1 until row 50, it is equal 13 inches length. It measuring from the upper arm until below the ear bowl. Next, we are going to make the belt sleeves by making increasing stitch. Continue from where your last stitch is. For row 51, chain 2, turn your work and make 4 V stitches. Then I will meet you back again. After you got 4 V stitches, then we are going to make increase. Skip 2 stitches and make V stitch into the 3rd stitch. After you got a V stitch, then we are going to make another V stitch into the same loop. And now you got 2 V stitches in the same loop. Next, keep repeating this by make 4 V stitches and then increase around until you reach the end of the row. Then make slip stitch. Thank you. Next, photo 52, chain 2, turn your work and make V stitch into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. So for row 52, we are not making increasing stitch. After you have made a slip stitch, next for row 53, chain 2, turn your work and make 8 V stitches. And then make increase. Keep repeating this by make 8 V stitches and then increase around until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. And for row 54, just make normal V stitch around, no increase. For the next row, you just follow the description I show on the screen until you reach row 77. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach row 77, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, for the remaining yarn, please use the needle to weave in. For the measurement from row 1 until row 77, it is equal 22 inches length. Next, please repeat the same thing to the other side. And this is what your cardigan looks like. For the last part, we are going to make the lace for the front tie. To begin, make a slip knot and chain long enough for the front tight lace. After you reach your desired fit, then for row 1, skip 1 chain and make single crochet into every chain until you have one last chain. Then I will meet you back again. After you had one last chain, then we are going to make slip stitch into that last chain. Then leave a long tail of yarn and cut it off. And tie this both strand of yarn together. For the remaining yarn, please use the needle to weave in. And this is what my front tight lace looks like. For this cardigan, you can make it in two styles. First, we weave in the lace into the corner part of the V-neck. And then make a bow. And here you got the first tie. And for the second tie, you can weave in the lace until you reach the bottom of the cardigan. After you had weave in both lace, then push it up to create the ruffle or the ruche, and then make a bow. And this is how we made the second style. And now your crop lace cardigan is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.